The very famous model what we have is this model. Challenging yourself from a zone of unconscious incompetence to a zone of unconscious competence. It's a tongue twister. But what this model is talking about is how do we transition from a zone of unconscious incompetence, which means I'm incompetent, but I'm not even aware about this fact. I am incompetent, to a zone of unconscious competence. What is unconscious competence? Unconscious competence means that I am doing the right thing without even realizing that I am doing things in a right manner. So this is the very famous model which is there, which is called as the coaching model. How do I transform myself from unconscious incompetence to a zone of unconscious competence? That is a model which I'm going to talk. So this is referred from this person, Martin and Broadwell, who has come out with this model, which is called as the four level of teaching model. Or it is, there are various variations of this model, but he came out with this model, which is called as the four level of teaching model, what we have. Now, if you look at this model, at the extreme bottom is the zone, which is called as wrong intuition. Wrong intuition is the zone, which means I am doing things in a wrong way, but I don't even realize it. I don't even realize that I'm doing things in a wrong way. Like probably this could have happened with Yelena suddenly in that match or in that game, right? She would have suddenly realized that, oh my God, I'm doing something wrong, but I'm not able to figure it out. Why are things going so wrong? What is the reason that things are turning out to be so bad for me today, tonight, right? So she is in that zone of unconscious incompetence. Someone will have to come and tell you that you are doing it in a wrong way. And that's when you come out in a conscious incompetence zone. Like, I'll give you my personal example. So my personal example was when I was learning to drive a car. When I was trying to learn to drive a car, the first day I made a blunder. I made a mistake between accelerator and a brake. So I could not really figure out which is an accelerator and which is a brake. And I'm talking about a geared car. In India, we had geared cars in those areas, in those era, if I were to put it. So I did a major blunder between accelerator and brake. Luckily, the instructor was beside me. The driving instructor could save the situation. And he actually reprimanded me. He said that you don't even know basics about car driving. How come you are here to learn something? First, at least do some study. First, at least learn the basic ABC mechanism of a car, accelerator, brake, and clutch. So what he did, he gave me a punishment. He said that for next 10 days, you are not going to drive a car. You are going to just sit and observe. It's okay. I'm okay that because at least you will at least understand what is a fundamental mistake you are doing. So for next 10 days, you are not going to drive the car at all. So he put me into that. He made me aware of that lacking skill. He made me aware that I lack a particular skill. So what happened? Next 10 days, I was just observing my co-driver, how he or she was driving the car. I was just trying to look at his or her foot movement. I was trying to look at how exactly the clutch mechanism works, how exactly the gear shift happens. That is what I was trying to do for next 8 to 10 days. So I entered into a zone of conscious incompetence. I became aware about a particular skill, lack of a particular skill. After 10 to 15 days, I again got an opportunity to come in front of the wheel. And then I learned it quickly. I learned it very, very quickly. So I put a challenge myself that next time when I go to the when I sit behind the wheel, I'm not going to make that blunder, right? I started looking at people. I started observing people who were actually driving car. I also started observing my relatives very closely, how they drive the car. And then I had made a commitment to myself that come what may be, I'm not going to actually now take it lying down. I'm going to make sure that I will do the right analysis. I will understand the right way of driving a car, right? So that is when I entered conscious competence. Today, if you ask me, as far as car driving is concerned, I am in the zone of unconscious competence. What is unconscious competence? I don't even realize that I'm driving a car. I mean, it is so naturally it is coming to me that I know that, okay, how I have to do the reverse parking, how I have to do the reverse, how I have to do the parallel parking. I have become mastered in that skill. But again, this journey was not an easy journey. This journey, what I created, was not an easy journey. It came with lot of trials, lot of tribulation. This journey came with lot of those trials which I had to take. And believe me, I had to challenge myself. I, as a person who was learning car driving around that time, I had to challenge myself a lot. And I had to make sure that when I'm challenging myself, I'm putting myself in the shoes of the instructor. So I'm going to put myself into the shoes of the instructor. And then I'm going to challenge myself, and then I'm going to be a better of myself. So the journey of continuous improvement, if I were to put it, the journey of continuous improvement will not come if you don't come out of your comfort zone. Many of us try to be in our comfort zone, right? We say that, yeah, things are going on well, right? Why change something? Why should I change? I mean, things are really going on well. So it is better to maintain the status quo. But believe me, status quo will put you back. Status quo will again send you back by at least few years. So as they say, right, the only thing permanent in the world is change, which means change is constant. You have to adapt yourself to the change. You need to adapt yourself to the change, and you need to make sure that at the end of the day, change is something what we are constantly looking at, or we are always looking at change per se is what we are constantly looking at. So that's what is the only thing which is permanent, as we say. So this is one of the models. This is one of the models which will help you to challenge yourself. This is one of the models which will help you to come out of the comfort zone and go into that growth zone. Okay, so this is a model what we have. And definitely one of the ways I need to do is I need to identify where exactly I am today. Am I in the zone of unconscious incompetence? Am I in the zone of conscious incompetence? Which zone I am? And accordingly, I need to have a strategy. Accordingly, I need to have a strategy to challenge myself and move into that next zone what we have. Yeah. I know I have covered a substantial portion so far. Any quick questions anyone has before I move ahead? Anyone, any quick questions? Maybe I can take one question. If you have, you can type in here in the chat box and I will have a look at it. So there is a membership link given there. In case you are interested to join the Expert Agile Club, please click on the link and please join the club. You'll get to hear a lot of interesting speakers, right? In near future also, you'll come to hear a lot of interesting speakers. Okay, I don't see any questions which have come up. No worries. Now let us go and try to understand, and let us try to understand another interesting tool, right? So I'll talk about another interesting tool.